make a big noise playing in the street. Gonna be a big man someday. You got mud on your face, you big disgrace. Kicking your can all over the place, singing, we will rock you.
My name is Lexi Littleton, and this is the 2023 Women's High School Volleyball Team Spotlight. We finished second in conference this year, and our varsity volleyball team did very well. We advanced to the third round of regionals before losing to Highland Tech. Our players that made all-conference were Haley Dry, Aniston Belk, Liz Bryson, and Ella Honeycutt was an honorable mention. Here is our coaches, Ms. Carter and Ms. Burris, with their interviews, as well as two player interviews from Haley Dry and Aniston Belk.
Hi, I'm Lexi, and this is for the Fall Sports Spotlight for varsity volleyball. This is Coach Carter. I'm going to be asking her a few questions. First one is, how did the season go overall?
We did really well. We made it to the Sweet 16 this year, and we haven't done that in a really long time.
And then, why did you decide to coach volleyball?
I like making a difference and seeing kids go to their full potential.
And then, what's your favorite thing about coaching?
My favorite thing about coaching is actually watching the kids be successful and see that they can actually do something that they don't see that they can always do.
And then, will you be coaching next season?
Yes.
And what was your favorite memory from this season?
I think when we beat Allegheny in three, being able to say that we beat the number, I think they were number eight team, and we were ranked number seven, and we beat them in three.
And that's our Fall Sports Spotlight on volleyball.
Hi, I'm Lexi, and I'm doing the Fall Sports Spotlight for JV Volleyball. This is Maddie Burris, and I'm going to be asking her a few questions. So first off, how did the season go overall?
Our JV team ended up third in conference.
So why did you decide to coach volleyball?
I decided to coach volleyball because I played volleyball in college and I just love the sport as well as getting to interact with the players.
And what's your favorite thing about coaching?
Just the relationships that you get to build with the players as well as the competitiveness.
And will you be coaching next season?
Yes.
And then lastly, what's your favorite memory from this season?
My favorite memory is when we beat North Stanley the second time.
And that's going to be concluding the JV Volleyball Spotlight.
Hey guys, it's Lexi, and I'm doing the player interview for 2023 Varsity Volleyball. So first off, what's your name?
Aniston Belk.
And what grade are you in?
I'm a senior. I'm in 12th grade.
And overall, how do you think the season went?
I think it went pretty good. I think we had like a little bit of a downward spiral in the middle, and then we kind of came back up when playoffs started.
And then, who's your partner in crime on the team?
Really anyone. I kind of get along with everyone, but probably Kaylee or Haley.
And then what's your favorite memory from this season?
We held a 2v2 tournament in the gym, and that was really fun.
And then lastly, what's your favorite thing about volleyball?
It's kind of like a way for me to clear my mind and focus on something different, and it's fun to do it with my schoolmates.
Yeah. All right, and that's it for our player spotlight.
My name is Avery Smith, and this is the spotlight for the 2023 Women's High School Tennis Team. The tennis team had a great season filled with many achievements. The team finished as YVC conference champions and were unbeaten in conference play. Following that, they also advanced to the state quarterfinals in the playoffs. Our doubles team, Sonya Rhodes and Rachel Flynn, won the conference doubles championship, and they also advanced to the state semifinals, but falling short in the final four. Ella Wilson won the singles conference tournament, and our all-conference players were Sonya Rhodes, Rachel Flynn, Ella Wilson, Natalie Niederer, and honorable mention Addison Furr. Overall, the team was very successful, and in the next video, we'll get to hear some insight from our coach, Ms. Niederer, and players Sonya Rhodes and Rachel Flynn.
Hey everyone, today we're here with our high school girls tennis coach, Ms. Niederer, and we're going to ask her a few questions about her season. First question is, how would you say your season went overall?
Our season has been amazing. In fact, we're still going. We're playing in the state dual teams tennis tournament. We just won yesterday, and so there are 8 teams left, and our next match is on Monday. We're doing great.
Okay, our next question is, why did you decide to coach tennis?
Well, tennis is something that I've loved since I was 4 years old, and now both my girls are playing, and I was involved with the team last year and really loved it. I've coached middle school tennis for 2 years, and so I just decided to step up this year and take the high school team as well.
So continuing talking about coaching, what is your favorite thing about coaching?
Just being able to see a change in the players from the beginning of the season to the end, seeing their smiles after they win. It's just been a great, great season and a great experience.
And we'll end it off with one more question. What has been your favorite memory so far about your season?
Well, so far we've had a winning record. We are right now, I believe we are 12-2. We have made it through three rounds of the dual team tennis tournament. We've had a team, a doubles team in the regional that was a regional finalist and heading to states this weekend. We had a singles player play really great. So it has just been a wonderful season so far.
Well, congratulations to you and your team, and hopefully y'all go even farther.
Thank you.
Thank you. Hey everyone, today we're here with two of our seniors from our girls tennis team, Sonia and Rachel, and we're here to ask them a few questions. So our first question will be, how long have you both played tennis?
I've played tennis since sixth grade, which would be about 6 years.
Played tennis when I was in fourth grade, then took a break for 2 years, and then got back into it in high school.
Okay, what would you guys say your favorite thing about tennis is?
My favorite thing is doubles, because it's really fun.
And you guys are doubles partners, I've heard. So what do you think your best match has been this year?
Definitely Mount Airy in the regionals, because we took them to a three-set match, and they had a really good record.
They're also the best team in the A1 group. Mm-hmm. So being 1A. Them 1A group. Yeah, there we go. So,
okay, and to wrap it all up, what is your favorite memory so far from this season?
My favorite memory is probably our match yesterday, because I came back from 2-5 and ended up winning the first set 7-6.
My favorite memory is being hit in the leg by a girl and then going the next changeover, getting an overhead, and then slamming that into the other girl's back, that same girl that hit me. So I enjoyed that.
She enjoyed that.
Sweet revenge.
Yep.
Well, thank you guys so much, and good luck to you for the rest of your season.
Thank you.
This is Lexi Littleton with the 2023 Cross Country Team Fall Sports Spotlight. The cross country team this year was small in numbers but big in strength. Their girls ranked 12th in the state and had 8 all-conference players. These were Georgia Sangster, Grace Eppenheimer, Addie G. Carter, Miley Swearingen, Sophie Sauter, Dahlia Waters, Brooke Limerick, and Anison Trexler. Here is their coach, Miss Swearingen, with her coach interview.
Hello, nice. This is Miss Swearingen, the cross country coach.
Morning.
So, how did the season go?
So, cross country had a great season this year. Our girls finished at the top. They finished number one in the conference. So, our top 7 runners this year all finished in the top and made all conference. We did have one boy to finish making all-conference, and that was Wesley Rogers. So far it's been a good year. We will go to regionals this weekend, and we hope to qualify to go to the next step, which is states.
How many students are on the cross-country team?
So our numbers are a little small this year, not as large as we've had in the past. So if anybody's interested in cross-country, come join us. We had about 15 girls, about 15 boys.
Why do you coach cross-country?
So, I have a long history of running. Running is something that has made me happy over the years. So, I love to be able to see students find a passion for running, and I love to watch them improve as the year goes on.
Anything you would change for the next season?
So, always looking to improve and find things to tweak our program. Definitely, some years there's motivation with lots of leaders on our team. So definitely want to find some good, strong leaders to come and join our team. Just try to help motivate students to improve their time every year.
And who are the seniors for this year?
So we have 5 seniors for the boys and for the girls. So let me see if I can go on memory. So for the boys, it is Wesley Rogers, Mark Lappin, James Bristol, Logan Seavey, and Dominic Renaggio. Our girls are Grace Eppenheimer, Anison Trexler, Anna Lynn Carter, Miley Swearingen, and Caitlin Barbie. Oh, I did good. Good job. And it's been a great year, and I look forward to next year.
Hey guys, welcome back to another Fall Spotlight interview for the 2023 cross country team. So I'm going to be interviewing a few players from the team. First off, what's y'all's names?
Mark, James,
Dominic.
And what grade are you all in?
Seniors.
Seniors, yeah.
And overall, how did y'all season go?
Went all right.
James. We got the regionals.
So yeah, we got the regionals. We always get the regionals. That's always the high note, is that we don't always win things, but we always make it the regionals, which is good.
Got 10th place at regionals.
Yeah, see?
Top 10.
And then who's y'all's partner in crime on the team?
Dominic.
It's all me. I do it all.
And then what is y'all's favorite memories from this season?
For me, it was thinking about food after doing any slightly difficult thing.
Definitely not the running. It's probably what comes after the running.
I second that. Snacks and milk are good.
And then lastly, what's y'all's favorite thing about cross country?
Not the running.
Complaining. Hanging out with them.
Yeah.
That's true.
Alright, that's going to be the end of our player interview for cross country.
Yeah!
My name is Charlotte, and this is your Fall Sports Spotlight for the 2023 women's golf team. This season, our golf team showed lots of improvement across the board. The team finished as co-conference champions with North Stanley and Union Academy. Hannah Lineberry was chosen for all-conference, and Rachel Parker was chosen for all-conference honorable mention. The entire team qualified together for regionals and states, placing third in regionals and seventh in states. Junior Hannah Lineberry won the 1A-2A Central Regional. Let's go talk to the coach.
Hey Night Fam, welcome back to the castle. We're interviewing golf coach Michael Phillips. First off, how did the season go?
The season was very successful. The girls ended the season as co-conference champions, with two being named all-conference.
That's great. What's your best memory from this season?
Probably having all five qualify for regionals and states, as well as Hannah Lineberry winning the Central Region.
And then why do you coach golf?
I've played the game since the age of 8, so over 40 years. I played 4 years in high school just to promote the game.
All right, and will you be coaching next season?
As of right now, yes.
Okay, and that's it for our Fall Sports Spotlight on golf.
All right, I'm here with two of our women's golf players, and I'm going to be also asking them a few questions. So the first question is, what is y'all's names and what grade are you guys in?
I'm Rachel Parker and I'm a junior.
I'm Grace Burris and I'm also a junior.
All right, so what has been y'all's favorite part of this season so far?
I think our favorite part was going into regionals and then finding out about going to states, because we're all separated out during the match, and then once we all get together at the end, we like tally up the scores, and once we realize we've all made regionals and states and conference and all those big matches, we all get excited and it's just really happy for us.
What has been y'all's like biggest accomplishment this season?
I definitely think that us going as a whole team to states is probably our biggest accomplishment this year.
Yeah, like none of us have split up. It's always been all of us going to conference, all of us going to regionals, all of us going to states.
My last question is, did you guys have any goals at the beginning of the season? And if so, did you accomplish them?
My goals were to just, have fun and see if I could see an improvement in the months that I've been playing, and I did, so I think I've accomplished those goals really well.
My accomplishment was like I was trying to go into states, and then finding out we're going as a whole team is even better.
Well, my name is Charlotte, and this has been the Fall Sports Spotlight for the Greystone Girls Golf Team.
My name is Campbell Bullard, and this is your Fall Sports Spotlight for the boys' varsity soccer team. The team had a great regular season, ending it as conference champions, and are currently heading to the fourth round of state playoffs. Some personal achievements from the team are the players who were named All-Conference. These players include Desmond Bullard, Michael Burleson, Colin Cape, AJ Cotone, Tucker Emerson, Arkin Pethel, and Cameron Morris. Desmond Bullard scored his 100th goal for Greystone and was named All-Conference Player of the Year, and Michael Burleson was named Academic All-Conference. Their coach, Bradley Harrington, was also named Coach of the Year. Now here are the interviews with Coach Harrington.
Hi, this is Campbell with your Fall Sports Spotlight for the boys soccer team, and this is their coach, Bradley Harrington. So I have a few questions for you, and the first one is, would you say the team has been successful this season?
Yeah, I would definitely say we've been successful. We started the year with like four or five like really tough games, so our record was kind of hit or miss, but obviously the teams we were playing was a step up in talent level from us or pretty equal. And we do that just so we're tested outside of conference play, so we're ready to come playoff time. But as of right now, we're sitting first place in the conference and then obviously have a good overall record. So I would say from a record standpoint and just from like the growth I've seen throughout our entire team from the beginning of August to now, I would say we've had a successful season up to this point, yes.
That's great. All right. And do you think you have improved from last year?
I would say yes, overall. From year to year, I would say each team's different. So the way I see improvement isn't necessarily that like the team this year is better than like last year's team per se, but the overall improvement of seeing guys from like last year's team who maybe didn't play a whole lot for us, they're now in like stepping up and maybe playing starter roles or significant roles off the bench, whereas they weren't contributing last year. From that standpoint, yes, we're a better team because guys have stepped into different roles and helped us in different ways.
Okay. And what is your favorite memory from the season so far?
I would say favorite memory so far is just kind of every day that we get to spend together out there on the practice field or playing games and getting to see kind of the relationships that those guys build with each other. Especially like the juniors and seniors with the freshmen and sophomores, just building that relationship with those guys and seeing how much the older guys really enjoy seeing the younger guys succeed, whether it be in practice or in games. And then when they do something awesome in a game, they're just excited for them to go score a goal or set up a goal as they are for themselves to go score. So I think that's always a cool part I like to see.
All right. And what are your predictions for playoffs this year?
Playoffs are always tough because, once you get in the playoffs after probably the first or second round, like pretty much every team can beat the other team. So, I think talent-wise and with how we're playing right now, I think we have the opportunity to make some noise and make a deep playoff run. But obviously some of that's kind of like matchup dependent and, a single elimination playoff. So you go out there and you play one bad game and a team beats you, then you're out earlier than you wanted to be. So, I like where we're at heading into the last part of the season towards playoffs, and I think we can definitely make some noise when we get there. So,
all right. And the last question is: are there any awards or accomplishments that a player or the team has made this?
The ones that stick out on the top of my head right now, obviously, your brother yesterday scored his 100th career goal for our program, which is a huge accomplishment individually. But like I told the team yesterday, to me, that's also like a team accomplishment because he's not scoring those goals without guys setting him up or other guys to assist him in those areas. So I'd say that's probably the biggest like milestone we've hit overall. A big one that we're hoping to hit if this interview were on Thursday is that we've yet to win at Union Academy since they've joined our conference. So we play them tomorrow night, and obviously I'm hoping that if we were to redo this interview, we can add that to our tally that our senior class now has beat Union Academy at Union Academy come tomorrow night. So,
yeah, I'll definitely be there for that one.
Sounds good.
Mm-hmm. Well, thank you, and good luck with the rest of your season.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm. Hi, this is Campbell Bullard with your Fall Sports Spotlight for the boys varsity soccer team, and this is the player interview. So, first off, what are your names and positions?
I'm Desmond, I'm a center mid. I'm AJ, and I'm a center back.
All right. Would you say the team has been successful so far this season?
I'd say we've been successful so far, winning conference and getting some big results. Yeah, I like to highlight the tie against Hickory Ridge, top 3-4A team. Mm-hmm.
All right. What is your favorite memory from the season so far?
My favorite memory is either the result against Hickory Ridge or beating Union Academy on the road to secure the conference win.
I'd like to add the Union Academy win against them on Pfeiffer's Field playoff game. Pretty strong. Yeah. All
right. Who is your favorite team to play this season and why?
I'd say I enjoy playing against Union because it's a challenge within our conference and it's usually pretty hostile, but I mean, I kind of enjoy that, honestly.
I think the Hickory game kind of pushed us to the limits and kind of showed us like what we are capable of, so I feel like that's pretty good.
All right. And last question is, what will you miss most about high school soccer?
Probably just the teammates and practices after school every day is really fun, and just going to away games together is fun, so just the teammates.
Yeah, I pretty much the same thing. Teammates and then hopefully the bus ride to Mount Airy. Mm-hmm. Should be pretty fun.
Thank you.
I've paid my dues time after time. I've done my sentence but committed no crime. And bad mistakes I've made a few. I've had my shins and kicked in my face, but I've come through. And I need to go on, 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 on. We are the champions, my friends, and we'll keep on fighting till the end. We are the champions, we are the champions. No time for losers, 'cause we are the champions of the world. I've taken my bows and my curtain calls. You brought me fame and fortune and everything that goes with it. I thank you all, but it's been no bed of roses.